front stretch here at Pocono, as Jeff said, the longest in all of NASCAR. The fable is that back in the old days, drivers used to pack a sandwich under their seat and eat the entire thing between turn three and turn number one. It's not quite that long, but it is full speed ahead by the time they hit turn number one. You'll see the noses dive to the bottom as they slam on the brakes and try and hug the bottom of this racetrack through that long, sweeping, and minimally banked turn one here in the Pocono zone. The way to success at this end of the speedway, hug the bottom of the racetrack, right down on the white line, making sure that nobody's able to put a nose underneath you and try and complete a pass on exit. If you get too low, though, you'll get into those rumble strips that will tear up the right front, left front tire and cause problems later on in the day. It's a very challenging corner, one that we'll see plenty of action in here this afternoon. We'll cover it from high atop a billboard midway here in turn number one at Pocono. Now let's go to turn two, the tunnel turn. And Mike Bagley of Atlanta, Georgia.
Thank you, Dave Booty. Good afternoon, everyone. When the drivers leave turn one, it is a 3,055-foot run up the back stretch with a long pond straightaway, as it's termed here at the Pocono Raceway. When you get to the end of that long pond straightaway, this is a very complex and a very unique corner, one of the most challenging in all of NASCAR. It's called the tunnel turn. It's turn number two. It's banked 8 degrees, and the key is to get the car woe down, cut it to the bottom, and hug the white rumble strips all the way at the bottom lane of the racetrack. If you do that, you're fine. You can come through here double wide. Three wide is not recommended. When you exit turn number two, you can then swing to the bottom of the racetrack, open up the inside line, start a run on the short chute, and hopefully complete that pass by the time you reach the entrance of turn number three. And Kyle Rickey of Killingley, Connecticut.
All right, thank you very much, Bagman, and good afternoon, everyone. Once the cars exit turn two, they will spill onto that 1,780-foot short chute connecting turns through two and three. The shortest straightaway by far here in Pocono, but yet still longer than many front and back straightaways at several tracks these Sprint Cup cars go to. Once at the end of the short chute, the drivers will again stand hard on the brakes on entry into the 6 degrees of banking of turn number three, while hoping their car sticks in the turn's preferred line, which for the second year in a row here in Pocono is a groove and a half off the bottom of the racetrack. That is where lies a semi-new patch of year-old asphalt, about 10 feet wide, that runs the length of the short chute around turns three and back onto the front straightaway. That was where the hot spot was a year ago, and according to many drivers, there is still plenty of grip in that patch of asphalt this year, making it the preferred line. Always exciting racing at this end of the racetrack, and I'll have it all covered from a billboard just to the outside of the turn three catch fence here this afternoon.
Field crossing the start-finish line, Tony Stewart pulling to the inside, he'll go to the tail. Today's broadcast of the Pocono 500 is brought to you under exclusive radio rights granted by Pocono Raceway to MRN Radio solely for the private non-commercial use of our listening audience. Any publication, reproduction, or other use of the descriptions and accounts of this event without the express written consent of MRN Radio is